He told me he was going to meet up Sarah. She found his money. And they were going to count it together. He was going to choke her out, bring her to the bridge, throw her off. Preston was going to drive the escape vehicle, and they were going to bury the money and leave the keys in the ignition and make it look like she killed herself.
Okay.
Exhibit C2 that's going to be played shortly is the January 31st, 2017 consensual recording between Liam McAtasney and Anthony Curry.
Alright, so I'm hanging out with her. She has, we went to the bank, she took some money out, not all of her money. We're counting it out, and then she goes to walk out the front door. I choke her out, drag her. My biggest problem was the dog, and her dog laid there and watched as I killed her. Didn't do anything.
Nobody was there?
No, nobody was there. Even her dad wasn't there. He was in Florida.
Yeah, you said that he was
there. Yeah. So, I have to leave. I fucking dropped my phone at Sarah's house. My phone was at Sarah's house. Like,
wait, you left your phone?
Yeah, I lost it. I couldn't find it. I had to go to work. I had timed everything out. So that...
Fuck, why did you take your phone? You should have left it in your fucking pocket.
Dude.
What were you doing?
Strangling someone. I choke her out, drag her in the back, put her in the bathroom, and then I had to go straight to work. So Preston came over, took the body, put it in the bushes, and then I was at work. I had a full, like, night of work, except I left work a couple times, which looks sketchy. I look for my phone, though, which is a reasonable... like, thing to do.
Yeah, you don't look for your phone.
It's kind of, like, me losing my phone is kind of a good thing, because the cops are like, oh, he's hanging out there, he lost their phone, he's going back and forth between his house looking for it. And then, I get off work that night, go straight over, Preston and I go over to her house, take her safe, bring that over to my house, before we do anything. And we take her body out of the bushes and drag it over to her back fence, and I crawl, get into her car, and I back up. There's a security camera across the street. So I had to act like her. I watched her every time she backed out. She does the same thing. So I backed out exactly like she did and drove off.
Put her in the trunk?
No, put her in the passenger seat of her own car. And then Preston and I had these walkie-talkies to communicate with. We just used them again. So I was driving, and I had her buckled in the passenger
seat. So she looks like she's just sleeping.
She's just sitting up. And my plan was, for me, I underestimated my own strength and how much a dead body would weigh. Because...
It's weight?
Yeah. I got up on top of the bridge to throw her off. My plan was I was going to throw her off, run over, jump over the divider, and get into Preston's car. And I go up, open the door, unhook her, pull her out, start dragging her to throw her over, and then cars start coming up. I see, like, headlights coming. I try to get her over, and I can't. Fuck my leg up. Like, the weight from her body, like, made me fall, and my leg, like, went up. So now I'm limping, my leg's fucked up, and there's three cars coming up. So I grab her body. Dude, I had superhuman strength, and I threw it in the car, and I fucking picked it up, and her feet were up here, and her head was down there, and three cars go by. And I'm fucking losing my shit, because that easily could have been a cop.
Mm.
And then...
I mean, the police station is, like, right there.
Yeah, yeah. And then Preston comes over the bridge, goes around, makes a U-turn, comes up behind me. The two of us throw the body over, and then we're out. This is the thing about, like, heists. There's so much shit that you can't account for.
You don't know.
Yeah. You don't know until it happens.